Hello friends, my name is Pradyuman and welcome to my channel VMware NSX Cloud, where I share step-by-step videos for VMware portfolio products. If you like what I shared in this video, feel free to hit the like button and subscribe because it helps me to grow the channel so that I can continue to create quality content for you. Before we start this video, I would like to congratulate you for completing all the tasks in this series. And finally, now our nested STDC is ready for hosting different products. vSAN is VMware's virtual storage solution, which uses locally attached hard disks of ESXi host in a cluster and presents combined capacity as a data store. All hyper-converged systems are designed to use servers locally attached hard disks, but not limited to local storage. You have option to present SAN or NAS as well. In this video, I'm going to cover installation of vSAN on single-site cluster. In order to start, we need to present minimum 3 drives on each nested ESXi, one for caching and two for capacity tier. Let's go to our nested ESXi virtual machine and add these drives. As it is our nested STDC, keep the disk as thin provisioned. Allocate 50 GB to first disk and 200 GB to second and third disk each. Follow same steps on remaining hosts of the cluster. After presenting additional hard disks, it's time to create a vSAN port group on distributed switch and add vSAN VMkernal adapter on each ESXi host. As jumbo frames are required to be enabled for vSAN traffic, please set the MTU size 9K on distributed switch advanced settings. After configuring VMkernal adapters on each host, please test the connectivity by pinging vSAN adapter IP address. Now rescan all storage adapters and once newly added disks are visible, mark them as flash disks, which will be consumed in our vSAN cluster. Please be aware this step is only needed in nested lab, not in real world deployment, until you are asked specifically by GSS team. Now all prerequisites are ready but one. We need to disable HA on the cluster where vSAN needs to be enabled. Let's do that. Now navigate to Cluster Configure tab. Under vSAN, click on Services. Choose Configure vSAN. Select Single Site Cluster and in next screen, do not enable any service in your lab environment. But in real world, choose as per design decisions. Claim disks and finish the wizard. Wait for all the tasks to finish. Once done, create fault domains based on ESXi host placement in DC racks. In our lab, I'm just showing how to configure it. Under vSAN monitoring, perform proactive test for VM creation and network performance to validate vSAN. For storage performance test, we need to use HCI bench utility which generates IOPS for testing storage performance. With successful testing using proactive tests, I will conclude this video. However, I would recommend you to please navigate to each tab under vSAN in configuration as well as in monitoring to get better understanding of the product. Along with, please check the vSAN storage policy. Now feel free to leave feedback or suggestion in the comment section and don't forget to subscribe.